Welcome to Place to fine-tune your swing, dress for the course. Point three, the place to fine-tune your swing, dress for the course, club, or cruise, and get tips on the best places to play and stay at the right price. Vacation or staycation, host Dan Shube, along with his expert guests, will tell you where to go to play golf and vacation, that is. Now, here's Dan.
Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show. I'm your host, Dan Shube. And this morning, like we usually do, we're going to talk some golf, we're going to talk some travel. And in a little bit, we will be chatting with our guest, Michelle Keeley. She's the director of sales for the Southeast U.S. for Kensington Tours, a company that does individual customized tours for you all over the world. And we'll find out what's going on with them. Of course, a little bit later, actually remote, we've got Jerry Augustine calling in as well from Sea Dreams Travel. She'll be joining us a little bit later. Of course, you could always reach out to her at seadreamstravel.com or by phone at 561-310-9337. And right here in the studio with me, of course, from Legends Radio, we've got Mike McGann. Thanks for joining us today.
But of course, I'm not sure where else I'd go, but you know, look, this is basically my home as well, especially lately, but you know, things will pass. This shall pass eventually. And now is the time to start looking for what we're going to do afterward.
Yes, exactly. And what we're going to do now, I mean, I told you, I think I came in and my eye was like swollen because yes. My wife, you know, she was getting ornery.
Cabin fever.
but it's okay. It's okay. And you know, for those of you who don't know, our sponsor is where I usually spend my days, Labor Finders, and they have me working remote from home. But they are an essential service. So laborfinders.com, if anybody needs extra workers, if your business is an essential service and it's crazy busy, like many of those essential services, you know, food prep, servers, delivery people, stock people, warehouse people, cleaning people. If you need to desanitize your places, give Labor Finders a call and they will help you out. But staying home, it's not my thing. So I'm glad to be here. Of course, locally speaking, I guess as of this week, a couple of days ago, the golf courses here in Palm Beach County were shut down. Not considered essential. I would argue that fact. I don't know. People may lose their sanity.
Right.
So I live like you do up in Martin County, and the golf course that I look out on, Hammock Creek, is still open. And some people would argue that golf is the perfect thing to do because you can separate yourself from other people. It's, you know, about 130 acres of space.
Everybody was getting their own carts.
That too, because they're not that busy. So yes, you could have one cart. Of course, it could be sanitized. You don't have to share a ball, a golf club. A lot of golf courses are actually putting a little disc into the cup so that when you reach down to get your ball, you don't have to touch the surrounding part of the cup to get your ball. So you just grab your ball. That's all you touch. And the people who come behind you don't have to worry about where you've been.
That makes perfect sense. I was talking to a guy who said everybody was getting their own carts, but then all the people in the different carts were congregating. And
right.
He said, come on, you're kind of
well.
Killing
that
the
that's just
of this.
People's stupidity, and
we're social creatures.
Yeah, you can't fix that. But you know, they are saying to get outside and exercise and maintain distance, and golf is a good thing.
And let's raise the voting age to 40 while we're at it, please.
Based on that.
I'm going to stop. I'll stop now.
I always say on the show, I try not to get political, but sometimes we have no choice. It just goes that way.
Political. That's just, come on, kids. You're killing me.
Speaking of political, in Pennsylvania, they closed down golf courses, and somebody local, I think, filed suit against the government to try and argue that that was a mistake. So we'll see that how that works out. And, of course, the PGA, all their events are canceled for the next month or two. Golf courses like Augusta were closed, but now Winged Foot up in New York, of course, very close to New Rochelle. But that's where the U.S. Open is to be played in June. It hadn't been canceled yet, but the country club itself is shut down. So that could be an issue. My guess is that there will be extensions of some of these closed golf courses. It's not going to happen anytime soon. And then, of course, we've got, you know, scheduling issues. They're trying to, of course, reschedule whatever they can, like the majors. There's talk about the Masters taking place in the fall. From what I understand, it might be quite beautiful there. Of course, everybody looks forward to seeing it in spring. But from what I hear, it's not so shabby in the fall. So hopefully that'll be okay. But the problem is even with the majors and with some of the other events, if you start to compress everything, there's only room for so much. So some things may just have to disappear. For instance, the Olympics, a lot of the players last time didn't play because of the Zika virus. This time, a lot of the players wouldn't show up. A lot of all the athletes weren't planning on showing up. As a matter of fact, entire countries were not going to show up. So finally, Tokyo postponed until 2021. So that relieves a little bit of the bunched up schedule that we would have here with all the rescheduling to the fall. And also perhaps maybe we'll have a better chance for more players in 2021 to have an opportunity to play. There's still things like the Ryder Cup in the fall that we have to worry about as well. So we'll see how that all shakes out. This past week, Pebble Beach closed down. So for any of you who wanted to spend the $600-$700 to play around there, or, you know, the $1,500 to spend a night in the lodge, you're going to have to wait. So it's not, I mean, it's on my list when they call me up and they say that they need me to report on it and they invite me.
Right.
But when I have to give them my credit card at that kind of a price, not so much. Also, the White House, they canceled this past week the ceremony for Annika Sorenstam and Gary Player. They were going to get the Presidential Medal of Freedom. I guess they still will get it. They just will have to wait to get it.
Yes, not so, quite the same ceremony.
No, not right now. On good news from golf, how about a little bit of good news? The Honda Classic, which we know took place just a few weeks back when life was normal, they have already made a donation to the Palm Beach County Schools, $30,000 for laptop computers for kids that are underprivileged and don't have them and they can't work remote and do their schoolwork.
Wow. You know what? I love it when this type of thing brings out so many good things, because it really does. There are a lot of silver linings, and I'm seeing a lot of that happen, Dan.
That, yeah, it's great. And, you know, usually the wheels turn slowly when you have charities. You know, you've got boards and decisions people need to vote on. But to see that they're acting so quickly, because obviously the need is now. The kids, you know, as you meant, without getting political, we want to smarten these kids up. We don't want them not learning, so that when they get out of school, they know what they're doing, and they could be upstanding members of society. So thank you to the Honda Classic and their Honda Cares division that works on all the different charitable donations. They're doing a heck of a job.
Yeah, they really are.
All right, I think it's time for us to take a quick break for a message from our sponsor, and then we're going to be back. We're going to be talking to Michelle Keeley, the Director of Sales for Kensington Tours. You're not going to want to miss it. Stay tuned. We'll be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show.
Teeing off for the money, and I want to get paid. I've been playing with confidence. I finally found my game. I've been swinging easy and hitting it straight.
Are you tired of searching for the job you need with the flexibility you want? Whether you're looking for a temporary or permanent position, you need to call Labor Finders. We're already in your community putting people back to work every day. Select from hundreds of daily job listings with companies who are hiring all over the country. With nearly 200 offices nationwide, Labor Finders has temporary and temporary to hire employment opportunities for skilled, semi-skilled, and general labor positions, such as electricians, landscapers, flaggers, hospitality, and more. Connect with a personal job agent today to navigate your next career step by calling your local Labor Finders office or by visiting laborfinders.com.
Four. Straight down the middle. It went straight down the middle. Then it started to hook just a wee bit. And that's when my caddy lost sight of it. That little white pellet has never been found to this day. But it went straight down the middle, like they say.
And we are back, and thanks to Bing. Always enjoy listening to him singing about golf. I wish he still was playing golf. It was great when he had his little tournament going on there.
No, he's a local icon. I mean, really, Bingo was his name-o.
So, as I had mentioned earlier, we have as our guest this morning, Michelle Keeley. She's the director of sales for the Southeast United States for Kensington Tours, a tour company that puts together really unique packages worldwide, individualized based on your taste. And as I was studying a little bit about some of their offerings, I was salivating. I'm sure you will be too. So to hear what's going on with Kensington Tours, I'd like to introduce to everybody Michelle Keeley. Michelle, you there?
Thanks. I truly appreciate the opportunity to talk a little bit, especially during these challenging times. So just to give your audience a little bit about myself, my name is Michelle Keeley, as you said. I've been in the travel business for about 30 years and with Kensington Tours for over 4 years now. We are a privately held, but been in the business for going on 14 years. And what we do is everything is customized. We go to over 100 countries worldwide. You know, I know these are challenging times. So just to give you a little bit of background, and I'll talk more about what we have and what we offer. And we all know that travel is going to come back. It's going to come back stronger. And we're just, I think we're all really ready for it. But just to give you a little bit of what's going on with COVID-19, when it all broke out and the travel restrictions came, we had hundreds of guests in these, mostly in Europe, in these restricted areas. And within minutes, we had them on the phone, made arrangements with them through their travel agents to get them all home safely and adjust. And then we are just working tirelessly to just make sure any clients who have travel coming up with their travel, you know, working with their travel agents to make sure we make adjustments, changes, cancels, whatever is perfect for the clients. And it's really telling, and you'll see afterwards, there is some benefits with traveling individualized, meaning by yourself with your family or friends, to go through and really customize exactly what you want for your travel experience on that.
This is Dan, by the way, but when I traveled not so long ago, I'm the kind of guy, I like to do it all by myself and I find some pretty good deals. I mean, that's what I do. However, I took a look at some of the prices and the offerings that you guys have, and it really doesn't cost any more than me hunting for bargains. However, the amount of time that I spent doing that, and then, God forbid, anything does go wrong, to have the ability to pick up the phone, call your travel agent, give Jerry a call, and have you guys fix everything, it's just a no-brainer.
Yeah, and you're absolutely right. I think during these times, it's more obvious that your travel agent is so important. There's a lot of great deals, or they appear to be great deals on the internet, and you think you're saving a whole lot, but the reality is, who are you going to call when all this happens? And sometimes it's, you know, minor issues or what's going on now, and who would ever have, you know, even speculated it would have come to this, you know? So yes, a travel advisor is extremely important. And what I like to say about that, I mentioned, I've been in the business for 30 years now. I only work through travel agents or travel advisors. And it's the same thing. A lot of times there's a misunderstanding where clients will think that they're being charged more or, you know, different. They're not getting everything they want. But that is not the case. And in many cases, because the travel advisor has all that experience, you're getting a much better value in addition to the experience and knowledge of the expert.
Now, can I just address one other thing?
Sure.
In looking, you know, me and my wife, when we travel, we typically like to go on our own. And I'm just of an age where I'm not ready to be driving my own car through, you know, foreign lands where I don't speak the language. But in looking at other group type things, you know, being on a big bus with a lot of other people, I guess you could make a lot of friends and it could be really cool or not so much. And we kind of like, you know, the smaller groups. So can you explain a little bit about the difference between these private tours that you do and as well as the cost difference? Because, again, in looking at your pricing, it didn't look like it costs any more or much more.
Right. You know, we are private customized, so we are probably not going to be as cheap as getting on a bus with 30 other people. But as you mentioned, it's really your comfort level. If you want the camaraderie of 30 other people where you're on a bus and regimented for, you know, 15-minute restroom breaks and that kind of thing, that may be something that you're interested in. However, that's not what we do. What we do is customization, and we do work with most budgets from premium to luxury. So, yes, you can be yourself with your wife or a small group or a family. We do a lot of multi-generational family groups. And with that, you do have your driver and guide, but you do have your independence as well. And when you do the private guided, the nicest thing, and I always like to mention, you know, you can plan out your trip and you work with Jerry, your travel agent, with our destination experts. We have about 200 destination experts, and they are familiar with the region that we're selling. And they'll work out the itinerary for you. But when you're in travel, let's just say you're a bit more jet lagged than you thought, or the weather is bad and you want to change up your customized itinerary, you can do that at a drop of the hat. And that's the flexibility that you have with private guided. Normally, you know, hotels are premium to luxury. We can work with that. And when you do actually price it against some of these group tours, in the end of the day, it may be a couple hundred dollars more, but you're really getting an experience of the lifetime. And you can work with your travel advisor and the destination expert to help with the flow of what your price is. We work with most budgets. As long as, you know, you have a limit of what you want to spend, we can work with that as well.
Now, I'm looking at your website. Is there a place in this world that you don't offer trips to?
We do go to over 100 countries worldwide. And actually, for this year, we just launched the U.S. and Canada. And I think our timing was perfect on this.
Yes.
So,
yeah, you think? Wow, yeah. That's exactly right.
Yeah, and you know, the thing is, everything we do is customized. So I know golf is very big, with the audience. We have several itineraries with golf, or we can build that in. So, you know, I'm sure some of your clients want to do golfing around the world. You know, maybe others want to do shopping around the world. We can build it all in together. Of course, we go to the historical, you know, St. Andrew in Scotland, which actually I was just there in the fall, which was beautiful. But we also have other unique golf opportunities like in South Africa or Asia, Australia, New Zealand. So if your clients, you know, want to go and travel, of course, with their friends and family, but also want to do golfing, we can implement it with the travel, whether it's 1 or 2 days, or we can build the whole itinerary around the golf.
That's awesome. And we're just about out of time, so I just want to remind everybody that the best way to get a hold of a Kensington tour is, of course, to reach out to my co-host, Jerry Augustine from Sea Dreams Travel, seadreamstravel.com, or 561-310-9337. And go play golf, go shop, go anywhere in the world, do it customized, and do it with Jerry and Kensington Tours. Right?
Yes.
Well,
thank you.
Thank you so much for joining us this morning. And
thanks,
what we're going to do is we're going to take a quick break, and then we'll be back with none other than Jerry Augustine from Sea Dreams Travel. Stay tuned. We'll be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show.
When you see me tee up, you better step aside. A lot of men didn't. A lot of men died. I hook it to the left. A shanker to the right, I'll be looking for my ball until the dark of the night. You play 18 holes, what do you get?
Hi, this is Jerry Augustine, owner of Sea Dreams Travel. Are you planning a vacation? Whether it's a weekend getaway, cruise, or a trip around the world, Sea Dreams Travel will take care of every detail at a value you can't get anywhere else. we go beyond your expectations, save you time and money. Imagine your own travel concierge at no cost to you, creating lifetime memories. Share a bucket list with us. Call now, 561-310-9337. Ask about our weekly exclusive specials, extra perks, 12-month financing, and even learn how you can travel for free. Plan your escape with us today. 561-310-9337. SeaDreamsTravel.com.
And we are back. And whenever I hear that music, I think of co-host Jerry Augustine from Sea Dreams Travel, who is joining us remotely today, hunkered down, avoiding the virus. How you doing, Jerry?
Oh, I'm doing good, and I'm absolutely going crazy. How's everything there?
Everything here is great, and I was also going crazy at home, and I decided that I needed to get out and about, and there's no better place for me than sitting here in the studio with Mike and talking to you on the line here.
There we go. So great to hear your voice, Jerry.
Thank you. Thank you. I don't know if you mentioned earlier about the Real ID extension.
Actually, I have it right in front of me.
He's literally holding it up. He's telling the truth.
The two of us are on the same page, literally.
Literally.
Because I thought that was important because a lot of people were worried about that. So why don't you explain a little bit for those who are not aware of what Real ID is and the fact that it's been extended?
Well, basically, it's extended. It was supposed to be October 1st this year. The Real ID is when on your driver's license, if you use that for identification to get on an airplane or get into an official government agency, you have to have a star on your license. And everyone had to have it as of October and this year, but now they've extended it until October 21st of next year. So that gives everyone a nice breather.
See, I had to renew my license, and it comes back with a star, and I thought it was just me that they thought I was some sort of a star. I didn't realize.
It's because of the radio show.
It must be.
You're a celebrity.
Boy, I can't wait to get my star.
So the point is, if you recently had to renew your license, then you may be okay, so you should go take a look. But if it's been a long time, you may need to, or perhaps get some other form, I guess, of ID, a passport perhaps?
Absolutely. They'll still take a passport in the U.S. and or when we start flying overseas again, which hopefully will happen in the near future, if all is well. But to talk a little bit about what's going on with the airlines, of course, they've cut a lot of flights, but they've also suspended beverage service. And no more middle seats.
Is anybody going to miss the food and beverage or the middle seats on an airplane, really? I mean, maybe they should have done away with that a long time ago.
Isn't that a good idea? You can't even purchase food or alcohol at all and if your flight is less than 4.5 hours.
But I do think that they made some exceptions for restaurants within the airports. Obviously for to-go stuff, so you can bring your own food once you've gone through security, if you know, with a drink, et cetera. And tables, I think, are still open, although if I were you, I'd maintain your 6 feet of distance if you can.
Absolutely. They're trying. They're doing their very, very best. And even with first class, they're like Delta, example, is giving water only on first class. And as far as the Delta Sky lounges and other lounges where you used to be able to go and sit and wait and relax, those are all closed right now. And
they're not making it easy. I have a friend who actually took his boat to go to his house in the Bahamas to go fishing. And when he left, it was perfectly allowed. And by the time he got there, he was told to turn around. They wouldn't let him in.
Yeah, I understand that. You know, there's still 30 cruise ships out there and not being allowed to stop at certain ports and actually not even being able to get back into the, most of them are trying to get to Miami, Fort Lauderdale, and So that's difficult. And then when they get up, they all have to be quarantined. And so that's not good.
But no, I remember when we used to say how wonderful it was that we had so many of these cruise ports nearby to us. Now I'm not so sure if it's the best thing.
Exactly. I have one of my agents was on a world cruise, and they ended the world cruise somewhere in Qatar. They had them get off, and she got back 2 days ago, and it was 53 hours for her to get flights to get back. So yeah. It was a long trip, to say the least.
Now, looking on the brighter side of things, I do know that some of the legislation that has passed Congress this past week is a bailout for some travel industry folks. I know travel agents might get some assistance. The airlines, of course, are going to get some assistance. I did hear, though, that the government, in exchange for the assistance, may take a stake in the airlines, which will be interesting. I think they did that the last time, like with General Motors. Back in the Great Depression or recession, they had a stake that they then were able to resell to get the taxpayers' money back.
Well, on the brighter side, yes, I am going to be applying actually for some of those benefits. But on the brighter side, some interesting fun things with travel is they have podcasts like Women Who Travel, and is one of them, and that's highly recommended by Condé Nast Magazine, and then the Rough Guide to Everywhere. These are podcasts that you can actually travel without leaving your couch. So that's kind of cool, and learn all kinds of things about the world and places that you're going to want to go in the future. So that's what I'm kind of interested in, hearing all those podcasts and listening to those and having some fun with that kind of travel right from my couch.
The other good news, of course, is that there are some great deals for further on down the road. And, of course, the airlines are offering refunds if you book anything. For instance, I just noticed that Costa Rica from Miami nonstop round trip to San Jose, $173, which is crazy. Panama is also on sale dirt cheap right now. From Miami round trip nonstop, $216. And I know, obviously, I was talking before you came on the line with your friend, Michelle Keeley, from Kensington Tours. And as we've been discussing, that now is the time to book these tours because people usually plan these pretty far in advance. So now is the right time, right?
Absolutely. And it's the best time and the best prices. And they give you options if you decide that if things extend and you need to cancel, they allow you to do that. So it's very, very flexible. And now is the best time to really book for the future. Absolutely.
So again, thanks to our guest, Michelle Keeley from Kensington Tours. And if you want to book a tour on Kensington anywhere in the world for the future or any other tour, of course, SeaDreamsTravel.com is the place to go. Or you can always give Jerry a call at 561-310-9337. Right, Jerry?
You bet.
All righty. We'll talk to you again soon. You take it easy and be safe. And everybody who's listening, hunker down, stay home, be safe, and next week we'll be back with another edition of the Golf and Travel Show.
All right. See you guys. And guitar in hand, and every stop is neatly planned for a poet and a one-man band. Homeward bound, I wish I was homeward bound.
Thanks for listening to the Golf and Travel Show hosted by Dan Shube. Dan's here every Sunday at 7 a.m. to help you hit him straight, whether you're in Palm Beach County or traveling around the world. We'll see you next Sunday morning for more of the Golf and Travel Show right here on Legends 100.3.